Hello, folks. I'm here again with yet another video explaining how to do IELTS reading step by step and more systematically without wasting a lot of time, which is very much crucial in IELTS. As I always suggest this strategy, and I advocated this strategy even in my first video, that looking at the questions first is always advisable. So here I am going to start with another section of Cambridge Series 1, Test 1. This is Section 2, and we are going to start with yes, no, not given kind of question. We have a set of questions from 16 to 22. Now we are going to start with the first one. As it is yes, no, not given, we have to remember that we have to compare the statements with the writer's opinion. So let's get started. The 16th one, the first question is, London Zoo's advertisements are dishonest. I have already underlined important words, advertisements and dishonest, which is a yes answer. Let's see why it is yes. Going back to our passage, the first line itself says, one of London Zoo's recent advertisements caused me some irritation, so patently did it distort reality. See, distorting means to hide something, and to hide means it is not genuine. So that means it was dishonest. So London Zoo's advertisements are dishonest, and that is what writer thinks. So it is yes answer. Next is, Zoo's made an insignificant contribution in conservation up until 30 years ago. Now, here our keyword is 30 years ago, that we have to relate with contribution to conversation. But while looking for the answer, it is always better that we focus on 30 years. Okay, up here we have 30 years, so we will read little more in detail. Zoos were originally created as place of entertainment, and their suggested involvement with conservation didn't seriously arise until about 30 years. So before 30 years, there was no significant contribution. So that is yes answer. So zoos made an insignificant contribution 30 years ago. So that's yes. Next is, the WZCS document is not known in Eastern Europe. Now let's talk about, let's see whether we get anything related to WZC and its popularity in Western Europe. We'll focus here on WZC so that we do not have to while away our time reading everything in detail. Here we find WZC 1993, and here also we have WZC, so we will just read these lines along. The WZCS estimates that there are about 10,000 zoos in the world, of which around 1,000 represent poor quality, not related to what we are finding. Here also we have WZC. We'll try to figure out if we can find anything related to our question around this portion. Zoological Society London held the first formal international meeting in the subject 8 years later. A series of world conferences took place entitled Reading Era, and from this point onwards, conservation became so common as buzzword. The commitment has now been we have found WZCS, but nothing related to its popularity among Europe is given, and that is why it's not given. Another question is a zoo in the WZCS select list were carefully inspected. So zoos were carefully inspected as far as WZCS select list is concerned. Let's go back to our passage. We have to look at the number of zoos inspected carefully. Here it is. The WZC estimates that there are about 10,000 zoos in the world, of which around 1,000 represent a core quality collection capable of participating in coordinated conservation program. This is probably a document's first failing. So the WZC document was not successful here, as I believe that 10,000 is a serious underestimate of the total number of places as zoological establishments. So your writer thinks that 10,000 is a misleading figure here, and in short it means to say that zoos were not carefully inspected. So the answer to this question, which also gets its link here as well. One would assume that the caliber of these institutions would have been carefully examined. Examined is again inspected, but it appears that the criterion for inclusion on this select list, which might merely be that the zoo is a member of a zoo federation or association. So there was only one criterion included to get a place in the select list, and that is why writer does not think that it is carefully inspected. So here this contradicts with what is given in the passage, so it is no. Next one is, no one knew how the animals were being treated at Robin Hill Adventure Park. Here, Robin Hill Adventure Park will become our keyword, because Robin Hill Adventure Park is a name which can easily be spotted in the text. So let's go back to our passage. See, here we have Robin Hill Adventure Park was finally closed down following a damning report by a veterinary inspector appointed. That means that the question says no one knew, but here it says there was a report prepared by veterinary inspector. So the answer is no, because someone knew about how the animals were being treated in the Robin Hill Adventure Park. Question number 21 is, Colin Todd was dissatisfied with the treatment of animals at London Zoo. The answer to this question is not given. Let's find out how. We'll focus on the name of this person, Colin, which is easy to spot in the text. See, here it is, Colin Tuck. Colin Touch, another author of Last Animals at the Zoo. This. If the words zoos work together in cooperative breeding programs, then even without further expansion, they could save around 2,000 species of endangered land vertebrates. This seems an extremely optimistic proposition from a man who must be aware of the failing of the weakness. This. Okay, do we find anything related to Colin Touch, another statement? No. So, Colin Touch does not seem to have any dissatisfaction, or there is no mention of any dissatisfaction that Mr. Colin had about the animals at London Zoo. So that is why we can't find any cue about it, and the answer to this question is not given. There's not given. Now our next question is, the number of successful zoo conservation programs is unsatisfactory. So for us, the keywords are successful zoo conservation programs and unsatisfactory. And the answer to this question is yes. Let's see how. See, it says that there were, and we'll focus on breeding programs here. So here it is given, saved by captive breeding programs, although a number of these can hardly be looked upon. So we can't be so much hopeful. Looked upon has a meaning that it is not so much appealing. So the number of these programs can hardly be looked upon as resounding success. Beyond that, about a further 20% species are being seriously considered for zoo conservation programs. So the number is not so much appealing, and that is why it's yes, that number of zoo successful conservation program is unsatisfactory. That is all about question number 16 to 22. Let's move ahead to our next set of questions, that is multiple choice questions. The question starts with, what were the objectives of WZCS documents? We have four options available: to improve the caliber of zoos worldwide, to identify zoos suitable for conservation practice, to provide funds for zoos in underdeveloped countries, to list the endangered species of the world. Here one needs to understand a basic idea or basic strategy of doing multiple choice questions is that one has to do trial and error method when one is unsure about the direct or exact choice. Okay, now here our main word is objective. What was the objective of WZC document? Okay, then we find WZC here. So instead of reading everything in detail, we'll directly spot it here and read some lines above and below it. It says that from this point onwards, conservation became the zoo's community's buzzword. This commitment has now been clearly defined in the World Zoo Conservation Strategy. See, it says that the WZC document was primarily designed for the conservation only. See, here it says WZC, and we connected with this portion, and the suggested involvement with conservation didn't seriously arise until 30 years ago. That means, and then it culminated into WZC document. So its main aim was conservation. Let's go back to our choices. Here it says to improve the caliber, so no, that was not the aim. To provide fund for the zoos in underdeveloped countries, no, it was not. The list, to list the endangered species of the world, no, that was not the aim, because it is not listed in the given text. So to identify zoos suitable for conservation practice, but their main aim was conservation. So B is the correct answer. Next question is, why does the writer refer to Robin Hill Adventure Park? So what was writer trying to do by referring this park? To support the Estley of Wait local council, to criticize the blank blank blank, to illustrate a weakness of the document, to exemplify the standards in AZPA zoo? Let's see. See, we'll directly come to the point where we spot Robin Hill Adventure Park, one of the Estley Wait, which may be, which many consider the most notorious collection of animals in the country. This establishment, which for years was protected by Eslie's local council, which viewed as the tourist amenity, was finally closed down during a damning report by Veterinary Inspector appointed under Zoo Licensing Act. The situation is even worse in developing countries where little money is available for. Okay, no, we have got our answer here. So, see, to support the Eslie sale is a distractor. To criticize 19 Zoo Licensing Act is again a distractor. To exemplify the standard, which is not given at all. So, to illustrate a weakness of WZC document is the correct answer. See, here it says the situation even worse in developing countries where little money is available for development, and it is hard to see a way of incorporating collections in overall scheme of WZCS. So in short, it is criticizing WZC's failure, and that is why the answer is C, to illustrate a weakness in WZCS document. Next is, what word best describes the writer's response to Colin Todd's prediction on captive breeding program? So we have to see what writer's response is about the prediction of Colin Todd's. Now again, our strategy will be on spotting the name, and we have four options: disbelieving, impartial, prejudiced, and accepting. So if we see, then Colin Sturge is here, and this underlined portion, I guess, gives us idea. This seems an extremely optimistic proportion from a man who must be aware of failing and weaknesses of the zoo industry, the man who, when a member of the Council of London Zoo. So looking at this text, we see that Colin Sturge has over optimistic idea about the number of endangered species, which writer disagrees with, and it is writer feels that it is extremely optimistic, and he was not actually aware of the weaknesses of this. So answer is like it was disbelieving. So writer feels that Colin Sturge was overly optimistic and not realistic at all. So impartial is incorrect, because that is not the right feeling of writer about Colin Sturge's response. Prediction. Prejudiced and accepting, both are distractor. So disbelieving is the correct answer. After reading this passage, anyone can figure out these three factors. Our question number 26 to 28 ask us to mention number of factors which lead him to doubt the WZC's document. So we have to figure out three factors here. So first was the number of zoos unregistered in the world. That give the answer is given here. The estimate that there are about 10,000 zoos in the world, of which only 1,000 represent a core quality collection capable of participating in coordinated conservation program. This probably the document's first failing. So that was the first one. Factors which lead him to doubt. So the number of unrecognized zoo in the world is the first factor. Second is failure of the WZC document to examine the standard of core zoos. And the third is unrealistic aim of WZC in view of the number of species saved to the date. This can easily be done after looking through the passage. So there is, these are the gist of three factors which one can easily figure out once one has understood the entire passage. Sometimes without looking at the passage, we can come down to these three factors. So I hope this video is helpful to you in figuring out different strategies suitable to you. Looking forward to meeting you again with another video. Till then, bye-bye.